Hey, what's going on, everybody? Happy Tuesday, Testimony Tuesday. I hope and pray that you are having an amazing day, an amazing, amazing day. My name is Nichelle, and I am the Startup CEO to help you start, market, grow, and profit in your own business, in your life, and in your relationships, to help you prosper, to up-level to that next level so you can start doing and enjoying the life that you so deserve and desire. Today, I briefly wanted to come in and ask you, why are you waiting? I've been seeing so many posts talking about your life could be different in 6 months. Your life can be different in 3 months. What the heck is wrong with today? Why can't your life be different today? All it takes is a decision. Most people don't make that simple moment count. The decision to say that I am sick and tired of being sick and tired of living the way that I've been living. I'm sick and tired and being sick and tired of not elevating my life, my game, my choices, my lifestyle, my finances, my family, who I am as a person, and all that I could do and be with a decision. Your life don't have to change in 6 months. Your life don't have to change in 90 days. Your life can change right now with a simple decision. Now, here's the tricky part that most people miss. When are you going to do it? Why are you going to do it? Most people miss their why. All of us have one. We all have a why, but we don't know what we can do to help us get to proving our why to ourselves. That's it. It is it. You know, there's so much opportunity that sits in front of us daily that we fail to take advantage of, that we fail to pay attention to, that we fail to acknowledge. Some of us are so stingy being stuck in our own ways and in our own lack that we fail to acknowledge that everybody can help us. You know, no matter what message somebody is sharing, it can help you either go up or go down. And that message of prosperity, that message of wealth, that message of faith, that message of inspiration, that message of motivation, think about it. You can learn something from everybody, but the choice lies with you. Are you going to be too stubborn to receive the information? Or are you going to place judgment amongst somebody because they don't live like you do? The decision to change is a personal decision. I always say, and I've been saying this since day one, when you get sick and tired of getting the same results, you know, that's when people make the decision to change. Sometimes some people keep saying, oh, I'm going to keep on working it out. I'm going to keep trying and nothing is happening. We have to realize at some point you have to give in to the things that are not working. And figure out what can I do to make it work. So you don't have to wait 6 months. You don't have to wait 90 days. You don't have to wait till next week. And you don't even have to wait 13, 12 days before 2019. You can start today putting a plan in place to help lead, guide, and direct you to where you want to go. So if you have goals that you did not make or keep in 2018, now is the perfect time to write them down. Write everything down that you hope to achieve in 2018 that you did not achieve. You know, no matter what it is, if you plan to lose 10 pounds and you didn't do it, write that down. If you wanted to start a business and you didn't do it, write that down. If you wanted to travel overseas and you didn't do it, write that down. Because just because you didn't complete those goals in 2018, don't mean that you can't start back up in 2019. A missed opportunity is one never reached or achieved. And as long as you do not put the foot forward and move your feet, sometimes we have to move our feet. I find so many people stay in stationary positions because of choice, decisions. They like to blame it on, I don't have time. Well, you have just as much time as Beyonce, and I've said this before, you have just as much time as anybody else that has time to do things to elevate their life. Everything boils down to a choice. And when we make different choices in our life, we find different things happening. Okay? So results happen because of choice. Results happen because of the decision that you make to say, look, this ain't working the way it used to. If I want to elevate in every area of my life, which you should want to elevate in every area of your life. You want to make sure that you're healthy because your health is your wealth. If you're not healthy, you can't do a dang on thing because you're going to be incapacitated up in some bed. I know I do home health. Okay. That's one of my businesses. And people tell me on a regular basis, I wish I coulda, woulda. And when I'm sitting at the bedside of somebody who is perhaps sometimes getting ready to transition over to the other side and they tell me they wish they coulda, woulda, hadda, you know, it really makes me think, personally, it makes me think that every opportunity that's put in front of me, no matter if I agree with it or not, I'm going to first look to see if it's for me. And if it isn't for me, then I'm going to share it with somebody else. It may be for, because that's another thing that we don't do. We don't share opportunities with people that can help enable them. A lot of people are stuck. I know at some points in my life, I'll be stuck. You know, nobody, just because we're on here broadcasting, just because it seems like life is going right, you know, as a business owner, there are so many days that I want to quit, but I know my why. I know my purpose, and my purpose and my why is to continue to excel because I have people that call me mom, that watch me on a regular basis. I have people that call me daughter, that love me and that have invested in me education wise, sending me through college and all of that. Growing, helping me to grow into the woman that I am. So I have those people that are looking at me that depend on me to be the best that I can be. And so if I don't do what I need to do, I'm letting not only myself down, but I'm letting them down as well. And we have to look at that. Stop being stuck in situations. Why wait 90 days? Why wait 6 months? Why wait to 2019 to change your life when opportunity is available right now? And all you have to do is make the decision that I'm ready to change. I'm ready to see some results in my life. And if you're not able to get results by yourself, because see, one of my defaults is I don't like to exercise, and I know I need to because it's part of health. And if I want to maintain a whole healthy life, then I need to get my tail out there and start running, doing something like that. But I don't like doing that. So I try to do extra things like parking far so that I can walk to my destination and at least I can get some type of exercise in. You know, I do a little cardio. That extra walking is cardio. You know I eat healthy. I do eat healthy, but I know that just eating healthy is not going to help you maintain a healthy lifestyle. You got to work out. You know, if I want to keep my skin looking clean and smooth and all that, I got to make sure to drink my water every day and make sure that I'm not polluting my mind with different things, because your mind is your health too. That's why we got so much mental health illnesses around here. You know, as a PhD student studying mental health, people are sick. Why are they sick? Because they infiltrate their minds with all of the pollution that goes on in our world that intoxicates their mind with stupidity. And when you get all that stuff in your life, look, if you are prone to and susceptible to that type of lifestyle or people, those things, then you get stuck. And it's okay to be stuck, but it's not okay to stay there. It's okay to be stuck, but it's not okay to stay stuck. Because if you're okay with staying stuck, then you're lost. That means you need to get some help. All right. So why wait 6 months? Why wait until 2019? Why wait 3 weeks? Why wait 90 days to change your life? Now you have the opportunity. I say this all the time, and it is no, you know, you don't have no promises. God ain't promised you more time than he gave somebody else. You don't know if tomorrow gonna come. And so if you got an opportunity to live your best life today, my suggestion is that you do that. And not only that, live large. Live the best life you possibly can. And everybody's living large is totally different. You know, my living large is making sure that I have the lifestyle that I've been accustomed to. I love my lifestyle. I love it, love it, love it, love it. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. You know, so whatever you like, whatever you enjoy, whatever makes you happy, whatever sets your soul on fire, make sure you elevate in it. Make sure you do whatever it takes to keep that life that you enjoy. And so that's my message for you today. I pray that it maturates in somebody's spirit and their soul. If this message has helped you and you know somebody is waiting for 90 days, 60 days, whatever, next year to get their life together, send this message to them. Forward it. Share it. Share it is caring. And I pray that God elevates your mindset to not be so stingy with yourself. I pray that he gives you the mindset to know that you got to invest in yourself if you want somebody else to invest in you. All these people starting businesses, but they don't want to invest in their business. Who does that? Literally, you know, and someone asked me the other day, well, people always want to charge stuff. Look, you know, do you know how much a college education is? College is not free. Why do colleges charge? Because they're giving information away. Information ain't free all the time. You may get some free things, but you got to invest to up level. You know, the free stuff is just going to get you in the door. But in order for you to elevate, you got to invest in yourself. let me just put it in perspective for you. If you have a job and you're on a job and you keep doing the same thing, but you don't get no experience doing other things within that corporate place, you don't learn how to do billing, you don't learn how to do customer service, you don't learn how to do management, you're going to stay stuck in that position. But in order to elevate, you got to learn how to do other things. And, you know, and that's typical in today's corporate society. You know, people are doing multiple jobs. Take advantage of that. You know, in the workplace, when I was there, I made sure that I did everything that I could learn. One, because I didn't want to do it in my business. I wanted to make sure I understood it. And then number two, it gives you more experience to add to your resume, your CV. You know, make sure you take advantage of every opportunity that's presented to you. You know, don't be a fool, though. Don't be a fool, but learn as much as you possibly can, because it can only help you get better in everything that you do. So again, my name is Nichelle. If you like positive information, inspiration, motivation to push you out of your comfort zone and into the next level, into your why, into your purpose, what God has for you, connect with me here. And I'm also on Instagram at Nichelle Womack. I'm also on YouTube. I'm everywhere where information is available. Okay. So thanks, blessings, and peace. And make it a great day. If you like podcasts, don't forget to subscribe to the People Connect podcast. Just started a new podcast too, at Love Thy Marriage. If you're in a relationship, if you are thinking about getting married, if you want to stay married, I've been married myself for 23 years. Nobody but God. Believe me. Because self is stingy. Yeah, I'm like, look, I ain't got to deal with all that. But self, we have to learn how to control self. Sometimes it's hard. So if you like marriage, if you're interested in relationships, check at Love Thy Marriage out on Instagram, and also check the podcast out. It's on Google, it's on Stitcher, wherever you want to reach it. We're going full bloom and full blast in 2019. We're just doing some preemptive things now, getting our messages together so that we can share relationship and help people to stay married once they leave the altar. Okay. So thanks again for being a part of my space. I greatly appreciate each and every one of you that I met in 2018 that has helped to elevate my mindset, that has enabled me to think on a bigger and broader spectrum. You know, again, like I said, we can learn from everybody, even if they teaching the wrong stuff. We can still learn from them what not to do and how to do it better. I truly believe that. I'm Nichelle, signing off for now. Make it a blessed, profitable, and prosperous day. Take care. Bye-bye.